Cecil, Summer Breeze makes me feel fine. Scott, we are your hosts for this very special simulcast of CWF Worldwide and Modern Vintage Wrestling. Cecil, Scott, we are 1 week away from absolute justice, and Nick Richards has got his dream matchup just 7 days before the fight of his life.
Right, he has a chance to go into that fight with a huge amount of momentum. He's teaming up with his hero, Tommy Dreamer, and he could go in and potentially become a double champion in the next week.
1 week from tonight on CWF Worldwide, it will be a special double-sized episode featuring Absolute Justice 2017 in its entirety. We know that Nick Richards will challenge for the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship on that card. He will face the winner of Trevor Lee versus Michael Elgin. So really, no matter who's in the main event in Absolute Justice, all three of those men are in a huge, huge, huge matchup just 7 days before the Supercard of the Summer. Richards firing away at Big Zane Dawson. Richards knows the Dawson family very well.
Yes, he does.
And really, Richards.
He's got a quickness edge on Zane here.
Yes, he does. Richards will be the quickest man in the matchup, holding Dawson by the beard and just drilling him, raining down shots.
Now, if you're Richards, you got to be careful. He has a big chance of being a double champion potentially. But you mess up against these Dawson boys, he may not make it to Absolute Justice.
That's a great point. He could find himself injured.
Oh, nice reversal there by Zane.
Richards up, cross body, cover!
You see it in the step of Richards. It's like a little extra pizzazz, a little extra zip in Richards tonight. That's good.
Yes, it is. Richards having the biggest month of his professional career. Went to tag in Dreamer, but Dawson brothers want no part of it. In comes Big Dave Dawson.
Big Dave and Richards are still going to stand and fight.
Mid-Atlantic Auditorium wants to see the extreme original.
As old as you feel, and I'm 100 apparently.
There's the tag, and the innovator of violence, Tommy Dreamer, stepping into the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium ring for the very first time.
I am old, but you know what it's called, experience.
That's right, it's experience.
Dreamer, such a fan of classic American pro wrestling. He's very impressed by the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium. Said it reminded him of some of the great venues of old. And of course, we are so thrilled to partner with Modern Vintage Wrestling here tonight. Dreamer, hooking Dawson. No, sir. Swing and a miss. Boom! Dreamer, firing away. Multiple shots. You see the polka dots down the leg of Tommy Dreamer.
Got a flip-flop and fly. Yes, sir. Oh, Dave having no part of it.
Dawson hits the ropes. Oh, time again. There's one for Zane. Tommy Dreamer ruling the ring right now.
Bionic elbow never misses, brother.
All of us here at CWF Worldwide so thrilled to partner with Modern Vintage Wrestling on this very special broadcast. We encourage all of our followers, all of our listeners, to like Gimmick Tree Entertainment and Modern Vintage Wrestling on Facebook. Follow along at Gimmick Tree and at Modern Vintage W on Twitter. Our friends at Modern Vintage Wrestling and Gimmick Tree Entertainment making this very special event happen. A simulcast of CWF Worldwide and Modern Vintage Wrestling.
Huge,
huge matchup, and the Mid-Atlantic Tag Team titles are on the line here. We cannot stress that enough.
Yes, first defense for the Dawsons.
What a first title.
Yeah. That is, I want to talk for a second. This is a real thrill for me to be able to call a Tommy Dreamer match. You know, I don't want to make you feel old, but some 20 years ago, I found this little thing called ECW, but it saved me as a pro wrestling fan, and Tommy Dreamer was a big part of that. So this is a thrill for me.
Oh, dear. Yeah, when I was growing up in high school, middle school, nothing excited me more than Extreme Championship Wrestling. And what an honor it has been to work with Tommy Dreamer this weekend and have him on this.
Class guy.
Yeah, absolutely. Have him with us on this Modern Vintage Wrestling loop. We're so thrilled for Modern Vintage Wrestling to be working with CWF Mid-Atlantic here. It's a packed house on a hot summer night in the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium.
Just heat makes me glad I'm retired again.
A lot of things make me glad you're retired. Especially those old uploads on YouTube.
Hey.
Oh. Richards from behind. Richards may look for the cutter. No, oh, sir. Drop toe hold. Dreamer slips in. He's got the count of five.
Oh, right to the back of the head of Big Dave Dawson.
A little Midnight Express action. A little bit of a dusty spin on it. Clayton Carter on the outside, not happy with it.
Now watch out. He's up on the apron.
Carter switch one at the ankles of Richards. Referee Josh Baird did not catch it.
Barely missed that.
Clayton Carter, I understand. I've done a little bit of research. Clayton Carter is the owner of several businesses on the Carolina coast. He has employed the Dawson brothers several times in the past for some tasks that he needed handled.
Well, let's just be real. There's only one type of business that makes money on the East Coast.
Nonetheless, if he is running with the Dawsons, Clayton Carter is not a man you want to mess with, if for no other reason than he's got the two bruisers from the Carolina coast as his posse.
And they have rerouted the momentum into their favor here. And I think we've learned that, we saw in that title win against the Sandwich Squad, they started out really slow in that match. They had a hard time getting out of the blocks, and clearly things turned out their way.
And one of the most heated tag team matchups of the year was back in Chapel Hill when the Dawson brothers faced the Sandwich Squad, and they did what, quite frankly, some of us were wondering if there was any way to beat the Sandwich Squad. The Dawson brothers finally did it. Took a steel chair and took every misdirection they could come up with, but they did it. Dawson.
Big side slam. Cover.
Cover two. Gotta mention real quickly, Modern Vintage Wrestling all year long putting on the Bobby Eaton Tag Team Series. Very unique set of circumstances. At the end of the year, the two teams that have the most wins throughout the year will face off to crown the Modern Vintage Tag Team Champions. The Dawsons right now are 1-1 after getting themselves disqualified against the Sandwich Squad at a previous Modern Vintage event, and then picking up a big win against the formidable team of C.W. Anderson and Eric Royal in Fayetteville, North Carolina. This is the first time ever that Richards and Dreamer are teaming, so they're 0-0 in the Bobby Eaton Tag Team Series. But if they capture the Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Championship tonight, obviously that's going to mean future bookings for them as a team. Richards and Dreamer could backdoor their way into this thing. Cover! Only two. Ruby and Dreamer could backdoor their way into this thing, and if they end up with the most tag team wins in Modern Vintage by the end of the year, they'll end up in another tag team title matchup.
Absolutely. You know, it's a chance to really get pack a lot of gold into your suitcase.
Again, we encourage all of our CWF Worldwide viewers to follow at Gimmick Tree and at Modern Vintage W on Twitter. Keep up with all the action and the year-long Bobby Eaton Tag Team Series. Keep up with all the action of Modern Vintage Wrestling, bringing top stars Sting, Kurt Angle, One Man Gang, Ron Simmons, Jim Cornette, and so many more.
Oh,
and international stars that Modern Vintage Wrestling brings to your hometown. Cover two! Dave Dawson almost smashed Nick Richards for a three count in his hometown.
You know what I heard about this Bobby Eaton classic? I just assumed Bobby Eaton was in every match.
That would be an absolute classic.
Man, the Dawsons are ragtagging Richards here.
Bobby Eaton will present the Modern Vintage Tag Team Championship at the final event of the year. Again, keep up with our friends at Modern Vintage Wrestling for all that information. If you're watching us through Modern Vintage Wrestling, CWF Worldwide produces new weekly content every Wednesday night at 9 p.m. Eastern. Give us a follow at CWFWorldwide.com and follow us at CWF Mid-Atlantic.
Did you just hit me with a new URL, bro?
Brand new URL, CWFWorldwide.com.
CWFWorldwide.com, I think I can remember that.
Zane Dawson ruling the roost against Nick Richards. Again, one week before the fight of his life for the Mid-Atlantic Championship. Dawson looking out to this crowd, this capacity crowd at the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium. Richards breaks free! And Lauren Richards is slugging away here! Bow to the eye!
But there's 300 pounds between him and the spot of the ring he needs to get to, and that's his partner, Tommy Dreamer. Clayton just took a shot on Richards out there.
You know what? I'm not going to say too much about Clayton Carter because I really believe if the stories that I've heard about him are true, this is not a Jerry Carey, Coach Gemini type of guy. So I'm not going to badmouth him in any way, shape, or form because I don't want to go missing somewhere on the Carolina coast.
Fair enough, but man, you still got to call like you see it.
I didn't see it.
Oh, man.
Smash Richards, dead center of the ring, too. Dead center of the ring. If Dave Dawson makes a cover, Richards is nowhere near the ropes. But what a BS cover.
They just let him up. He saw Dreamer coming.
Yeah, Dreamer had his fist cocked, ready to swing on the Dawsons. Free Josh Bear losing control here. Yes. This is an inexperienced rookie referee.
Very young official.
Huge assignment for this rookie referee. Oh, crash game. Oh, man. Teamwork from the Dawsons is a real killer.
They've learned from the best.
You're a dead man.
Way too much time, and the winner of last year's Johnny Weaver Cup tournament escapes.
I don't think the third Dawson brother would have wasted that much time. Hey, we're gonna get tagged to the Innovator of Violence. Yes, sir.
Dreamer's in. Double D. Dave Dawson is in.
Oh, it baited Dave into that corner.
Dreamer is looking great. Crossbody cover. Two. Zane Dawson.
Last second, Zane Dawson made the save. Dreamer looking really good here. He's got a chance to add another belt to his lengthy resume.
Two-time ECW World Champion, former ECW World Tag Team Champion, and Dawson takes it right in the eyes. Clarence Carter, Clayton Carter may need to get free. Just here.
Clarence Carter. Nobody's doing the stroke out here, Brad.
Dreamer smashing that can. That's an interesting souvenir to have.
I don't think the kid wants to drink it anymore.
Good Lord, this thing is breaking down at the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium.
This place is turning into a bingo hall right before our eyes here. Man, can you imagine if Tommy Dreamer becomes the Mid-Atlantic champion with Nick Richards here?
Good Lord, I'd love to have these guys every week.
Oh, stop short, ducking the line. Double cutter!
Double cutter! This place came unglued! Double cover!
Two!
Oh, barely got up! Woo, down goes Clayton!
Clayton's down, watch out for Zane from behind. Shuts Richards out.
Yeah, Richards took his eye off the ball and he paid for it.
Dreamer's still the legal man, though.
Oh, this is bad. They have compromised Dreamer. No, they haven't!
That's an experience of Dreamer. That's 25 years of pro wrestling right there.
Quick thinking. Dreamer directed his partner. They've got one Dawson brother in and one Dawson brother out. This is a big opportunity here.
They got Dave in a compromised position.
Oh, look out! Zane! Woo! Richards flies off the apron onto Zane Dawson.
Man, Dave is out of it in that corner.
Is Tommy Dreamer going? gonna give us a big high risk maneuver?
We're gonna dive? Oh no, Dave! Cuts him off in the middle of the ring!
All that mass and weight just runs over Dreamer.
Oh god, get away from me, bro.
Oh, Dawson's right in front of us. Oh.
You gotta use that.
The Dawson brothers may aim for the disqualification here.
Yeah, that's an instant DQ.
Dawson brothers will save the titles here.
Oh, Travis. DDT. Yes.
With it.
We're gonna be your champions. Champions! Oh no! What is going on here? The referee sees it. He sees Dave Dawson's foot on the rope. Oh no! It's not over. He just saw the foot of Dave Dawson on the rope. He didn't see it during the fall, but he just noticed it.
Did the foot hit the rope before the three count, or did the three count hit first? I'm not sure.
What's the decision?
This is an inexperienced rookie referee. Did the foot hit the rope, or did the three count hit the rope?
I think the three count hit first. We gotta make heads or tails of this. I think that was a three. The referee, we've gotta get a decision here. Dave clearly got the foot on the rope, but wasn't in time.
Josh Bear is saying, I blew the call. The foot was on the rope. Josh Bear is saying, I blew the call.
The referee, he's saying that's not it. I think we're going to restart the match. Are we restarting this thing? We're restarting the match. Dawson hits Dreamer with the lariat. The match is restarted. Dawson hit the lariat. He kills Nick Richards. Oh no,
the match is restarted.
He hit him with it.
Hold on, no. Two, down.
Zane Dawson hit Dreamer with the lariat as soon as the match restarted. In a controversial fashion, the Dawson brothers go into absolute justice, still Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champions.
With us tonight. Yes, yes, thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone, for hanging out. Guys, I'm 46 years old. This business isn't about me. It's about the men and women in the back that are busting their butts for each and every one of you. You guys know we say, thank you, Tommy. No, thank you each and every one of you, because if it wasn't for you guys, there would be no Tommy Dreamer. And the building similar to this, there would be no legends like J.J. Dillon, like the Four Horsemen, like Dusty Rhodes. They paved the way in buildings like this and sweat it out with you guys. From the bottom of my heart, I love this business since I'm 9 years old. It's because of each and every one of you that I do. Let's continue to rock this show. Thank you so much. God bless.
Is the number one venue for live pro wrestling in all of the Carolinas. But did you know that you can also rent the Sportatorium for all of your anniversaries, fundraisers, and live pro wrestling birthday parties? Check us out at CWF247.com to find out more about how you can have your event right here at the Sportatorium.
Cecil Scott, what an incredibly tense stare down. in this epic matchup brought to you by Modern Vintage Wrestling here at the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium, part of the very special Modern Vintage Wrestling and CWF Worldwide simulcast. Title is on the line as Cecil Scott, on a sweltering summer night in the Carolinas, not one single person has left the arena early because everyone has their eyes glued to the squared circle.
Absolutely, and this is one of the more unique Mid-Atlantic title matches we've seen in a long time. An international superstar in Michael Elgin, and let's face it, Trevor Lee, an international superstar in his own right.
Want to let our CWF Worldwide viewers know that we may go into extra innings tonight, but we will bring you this match in its entirety. A tense handshake between champion and challenger. Look at the stare coming from Big Mike.
And honestly, if this thing does go in extra innings, you got to figure that's Trevor Lee. That's exactly what he wants in this situation.
For our fans watching us on Modern Vintage Wrestling, Trevor Lee has been the Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion since February of last year. A title reign that is slowly creeping up on the all-time record currently held by Eric Royal. Michael Elgin daring Trevor Lee to cross the line.
Wow.
And oh, jeez! Elgin rocked the champion!
And this is one of those situations. Trevor Lee, he's going to have to tinker his game plan. He's going in there with a literal tank. Yeah, man, he honestly can't really outstrike and outgun.
So many classic Trevor Lee Mid-Atlantic title defenses have happened in this arena. We saw him sometime back on Modern Vintage Wrestling successfully defend the title against Eric Ace Royal, the man whose record he is chasing to be the longest reigning Mid-Atlantic champion of all time. That issue will have to wait for another day, because right now Trevor Lee is locked in combat with one of the hardest hitting, most powerful, most decorated wrestlers in the world. And Cecil Scott, what will Trevor Lee do to defend his home turf here?
I think he's gonna do what he's done better than anybody. He's gonna really draw this thing out. Maybe it's more necessary now than it has been in the past, where in the past it seems like he's done it mostly as a stylistic choice. Here, I feel like it's really a necessity. He's gotta test the gas of this big powerhouse.
For our fans watching us on Modern Vintage Wrestling, this bout in its entirety, no commercial interruptions, is available 100% free at CWFWorldwide.com. Wherever you're watching this on the planet, we thank you so much for your attention. We appreciate all the new eyeballs that this partnership between CWF Mid-Atlantic and Modern Vintage Wrestling has brought us. And Cecil Scott, this could end up being, quite frankly, the most watched Trevor Lee title defense of all time, thanks to this unique partnership, this matchup airing, quite frankly, all over the globe on Modern Vintage Wrestling. Shoulders down, only got two, as well as airing right here on CWF Worldwide. Trevor Lee has been in some classics, Cedric Alexander, Chip Day, Roy Wilkins, but this could end up being his most viewed title defense by the time all those numbers are calculated, coming in from both CWF Worldwide and Modern Vintage Wrestling.
Absolutely, and you know, if you look at the reality of the situation, big names equal a lot of clicks and a lot of views, and word of mouth, you know, adds even more. I think coming into this, we know we got a quick crucifix here, that we're not gonna get anything less than a stellar bout here.
Once again, if you are watching us on broadcast television through Modern Vintage Wrestling, that URL is CWFWorldwide.com to view this matchup in its entirety with no commercial interruptions. Trevor Lee.
I'm noticing a very deliberate approach from Michael Elgin, too. He's very...
Oh! Oh, he floored the champion!
One shot.
He floored the champion!
That is one shot took down this champion.
Trevor Lee literally looks mad at himself for getting knocked down.
I mean, how often do we see Trevor Lee get waylaid like that? I mean, the guy's built like a tree himself.
Oh, good Lord! It took everything Trevor Lee had to stay up, and Elgin shoved him back down!
And Trevor Lee had a full hit of steam coming into that big chest of Michael Elgin.
I don't think he had the balance, though. I think he was knocked off balance by the big man. Trevor Lee is trying to save face here against Elgin, who just caught the champion with ease.
What a power slam. And honestly, I think from a physicality standpoint, this championship reign has never been in more danger than it is tonight. And Trevor Lee, he's already signed on the dotted line to defend against Nick Richards should he get past this match.
Well,
and as a match in the back of his head, he's been thinking about for a while.
He has, but once again, we need to make abundantly clear, Charlie Armstrong and the other modern vintage wrestling officials have made clear to us that they have put a hold on the date for Absolute Justice with Michael Elgin. Should Michael Elgin capture the Mid-Atlantic Championship here tonight, then 1 week from tonight at Absolute Justice, it would be Michael Elgin defending against Nick Richards. Modern Vintage Wrestling making sure that if need be, the fans here in the Mid-Atlantic Auditorium will not get robbed of their championship matchup next week at Absolute Justice. Hold on here. Elgin, reverse. Trevor with the elbow.
Yeah, Trevor quickening the pace here a little bit.
Caught him, oh dear.
And the power of Big Mike. My God. Trevor's smart move. Can he get the STF on this big tree? Not this time.
Woo! Drop kick!
And Mike's still on his feet. Finally got it with the Rana.
Trevor Lee may need to utilize that Ultra J X Division style here. There may be no one as powerful as Big Mike. Trevor Lee will have a quickness advantage here.
Jeez. Oh my God, he didn't even flinch from that.
We caught him with ease. Trevor Lee trying to stay alive on the outside. Sends Elgin hard into the apron.
He stopped himself though, Elgin.
Oh, he caught him again.
Trevor.
DDT.
No, he can't pull it down. There's too much strength.
Elgin.
He caught him.
Is a damn man.
Buster on the apron!
Violently and awkwardly!
And I think at this point, if you're Nick Richards, you gotta start game planning for a different champion come Absolute Justice.
We saw Nick Richards team with his hero, Tommy Dreamer. For the briefest of moments, they were the Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Champions. This undeniably the biggest month in the career of Nick Richards, as he has a chance 1 week from tonight on CWF Worldwide of becoming the Mid-Atlantic Champion. To do it, he will have to defeat whoever wins this matchup.
And just imagine, he's mentally prepared for Trevor Lee for months to get himself ready for that battle. And if Trevor Lee, which is a realistic possibility, if he doesn't come out of this thing as champion, Nick Richards is at a pretty severe disadvantage in a lot of ways come Absolute Justice. Oh! Robbie Walsh being very deliberate with that count here, too. We want to see a winner. And what I've noticed from Elgin, very deliberate movements. He's not exerting more energy than he has to. The reputation of Trevor Lee is famous at this point.
Oh!
God.
Sounded like getting hit with a tree trunk. And they are playing with this referee's 10 count on the outside. Oh, dear.
Oh, dear.
Elgin. They chopped this whole ring down.
What a disgusting thud on that post!
Trevor Lee had to stay alive!
And that's gonna take away a huge weapon from Big Mike Michael Elgin if he can't throw those hands and those chops. Man, still got a lot of power in that hand though. I'm surprised at how much action we've had on the floor here in this one. Oh dear, going back to the apron maybe.
Trevor Lee. Oh, he's a new champ! Oh, and he stuck Trevor Lee on the apron and right back in the ring. Elgin will look to win it with a cover here, all the weight on the chest!
And you see how much energy Trevor Lee had to put out to push this 265. I would say looking at it, maybe 275, 280 off of that chest.
My God. Crowd here in the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium, 1,000,000% behind Trevor Lee.
Yeah, they've been with him every step of the way. They were with him for 105 minutes. They went through it with him through the summer. European uppercuts into this barrel chest. He's actually got Mike reeling a little bit. Reversal on the whip.
Oh, he ate the post.
I think that ring buzzed a little.
Good Lord, I think it buzzed a lot.
And Trevor Lee was really unloading everything he had there. If I'm Trevor, if I'm going to get to a striking situation, I want to look at maybe throwing the kicks instead of maybe the forearms and the hands. There's so much power in his legs, I think he could cheat the armor there. Of course, to do that, he's got to get back to his feet.
Big Mike pulling up. Carolina Caveman, the technical savage.
This is very good.
Down goes Trevor Lee.
And this is just a situation. I mean, Trevor Lee has looked, I won't say outclassed, but he has looked outmatched.
Somebody in the crowd just said he knocked that man out.
I think he did. Trevor Lee has just looked physically outmatched so far.
Oh, Trevor's down. Trevor's down, it hurt. In the event that Michael Hogan wins this championship, 1 week from tonight on CWF Worldwide, in your opinion, Cecil Scott, you've been in the ring with him, can Nick Richards hang with somebody like Michael Hogan?
Nick Richards always has a puncher's chance, but I think mentally, I don't know if he's there for Michael Hogan. It's because he spent months preparing for Trevor Lee. 7 days notice on this big man. Oh, the fingers.
No!
That has been a game changer for Trevor Lee in every title defense, and he couldn't get it.
Big Mike advancing like a hunter. Buckle bomb, no! I gotta believe Big Mike was going for the buckle bomb. I gotta believe Trevor Lee knew he had to avoid it.
I gotta believe if he had hit that buckle bomb, we would be looking at a new champion right now. But that big double stomp, I think he knocked the wind out of Michael Hogan, the challenger here. But Trevor Lee, he has had so much taken out of him.
Two of these.
Trevor pulling himself up. Hogan coming in, catches the elbow in the face. Trevor Lee still fighting. Got to create distance. Hogan has yet to leave his feet this match, but he just did right there.
The Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium is roaring and rocking for the Mid-Atlantic champion, German! Is he too strong? Is he too big? Yes, he is.
Hogan gonna try his own. Trevor Lee's on his feet. What an athlete!
Woo! Clothesline didn't take him down.
Hogan, holy crap.
Trevor Lee has got to avoid those strikes. The title is in jeopardy. Trevor Lee must avoid those strikes.
He's unloading now. He's putting everything he's got into it. They call Michael Hogan unbreakable, but Trevor Lee's breaking it down right now. Oh, man. Oh, God. Trying again for that German, but again he powers out.
Oh, dear. Double stop. Hogan crashes cover.
Pretty close count.
Hogan with those powerful arms was able to force Trevor Lee off him in the cover. And man, this capacity crowd here at the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium has not left Trevor Lee's side.
He needs this crowd more than ever tonight.
Title is in jeopardy. 1 week away from a huge title defense. But right now, neither man can think about absolute justice. Neither man can think about modern vintage wrestling or CWF Mid-Atlantic. They can only think about surviving this title fight, about what it will take to win the championship.
Third attempt on the German, got nothing. German coming in. Oh, they caught him. Oh, man. It looks like he shook the cobwebs loose. Trying to explode her in that buckle. Trevor fighting out. Roll through. Trying the arm. Yes! Got the elbow.
Finally got that arm work. Cecil Scott, we have talked about it in so many of those Trevor Lee title defenses. He likes to put money in the bank on the arm work. Tornado DDT. Weight is on the shoulders.
Only two. He may not have needed that deposit after that tornado DDT. Jermaine, even if he doesn't get the arm submission, he always goes back to that arm. It's kind of like a security blanket almost.
Trevor Lee going for that guillotine choke. We saw him utilize that guillotine choke against Chip Day in that historic matchup. Many people are already calling it the match of the year. If you have not seen Trevor Lee against Chip Day, visit CWFWorldwide.com to check it out. Trevor Lee may try to choke Big Mike out. Big Mike may be fading on this hot summer night. Big Mike may be out of oxygen. All right, crush. Oh, no, no, God, no!
Man, Trevor Lee fighting out, got the elbow to the head.
Oh, he finally got it!
That's two big blows to the arm. Elgin again, Falcon Arrow!
Planted it dead center of the ring! Two, no!
Every time Trevor Lee goes for one of his big patented moves, the strength of Elgin comes right back through. Man, look at him favoring that hand, though.
Yeah, that's going to affect your punching power, going to affect your ability to lift, to grab, to do pretty much anything.
Yeah, I mean, I don't care how strong you are, you still have to have your digits to be able to manipulate and grab and to do the holds. Oh, there you see it.
He may have found a way, the champion may have found a way of neutralizing all the strength in Big Mike.
And we did see against a bigger, stronger man of Rob McBride, the arm work did pay off, and he tapped him out with an arm bar. So Trevor has been known to go to the arm submission on occasion.
Oh, how is the champion still standing?
And it's hard. It's all hard and determination. He's poured every bit of his being into this title raid. But it might be about to knock the being out of Trevor Lee. Maybe that big lariat coming up. Oh,
swing and a miss.
German. Oh no, he's got him. He's holding on.
Oh, those powerful arms are locked around the champion.
Rolling Germans. That's the second one.
Good Lord. Michael Elgin may wear out the Mid-Atlantic champion here.
Trevor holding on that rope for dear life. I don't know if he can withstand another one of these Germans.
Oh, oh dear.
Got the arms hooked.
Oh dear.
Arms hooked.
What is this? Don't take a ring. No! Shoulders are down! Two!
Oh,
oh, he almost got him. He almost got him. Oh dear!
Oh, rebound German! Right to his feet!
Michael Elgin may add another championship to his resume right here tonight in the Middle East Auditorium. Oh! Two!
No! Woo! Woo! That was close!
Closest near fall we have seen in months in the title reign of Trevor Lee. The closest near fall we have seen since that match against Chip Day.
Yeah. Robbie Walsh, he was right on the spot there. Give referee Walsh a lot of credit, calling a great match here.
Champion and challenger both down. There is an electricity flowing through the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium like I cannot describe. We thank you for watching us, but you've got to come out live in person. You've got to see modern vintage wrestling. You've got to experience the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium.
Yeah, you got to feel this heat, literally.
Charlie. Trying to look for a rope, look for anything. Big Mike is back to his feet first. How do you stop this 265-pound unbreakable machine?
It's like the Terminator. Right, get that buckle bomb.
No. Boy, everything Trevor Lee tries, Big Mike seems to have an answer for.
Yeah, and it's just pure strength. Oh, no, rolling elbow.
Oh. Jeez, pumpkin! Oh. Oh dear! Swing and a miss! Caught him! Oh.
I thought he was using Elgin's rage against him there, but Elgin found that lariat out of nowhere!
Big Mike may have finally found the way to take this title off of Trevor Lee! Good God, what a lariat! Trevor Lee has beaten Michael Elgin once before. It was a historic matchup for a lot of reasons. It was the first time Trevor Lee ever had to pull out the small package. It became one of his calling cards as the crowd rings out with "This is awesome" chants. I wonder if Trevor Lee has got the wherewithal and the presence of mind to remember back to that night and to say, hey, maybe it's those quick X Division style tactics that can help me out here. Yeah. He has been put through a world of hurt.
Yeah, he's really got to dig into the bag of tricks. We might get the old favorite, the game changer, the turning point of every match of his.
He is stalking the challenger, the Mid-Atlantic champion.
Oh! Penalty kick and Elgin! Holy crap! Oh! Has anyone ever stood up to that penalty kick like that?
Elgin is still standing after two of them!
A third one didn't drop him!
Big Mike refuses to go down! Trevor Lee cannot take this man down!
Green velocity on the fifth one and he's still teetering on his feet!
Michael Elgin is still on his damn feet!
Number six! Oh, he finally goes down!
I don't know if it was wherewithal or if he just collapsed. But Elgin avoided another big shot.
Yeah, I think he got fortunate that his legs gave out on him there. Yeah, this is dead weight. He can't get him up. Hey, Trevor, get in there, land one big strike, and I think you've got this thing.
I don't know if the adrenaline has worn off on Big Mike or not, but he looks in jeopardy for the first real time in this matchup. Crowd is rallying behind the champion. Big Mike has been rocked.
Woo! One more!
No way! Jesus Christ!
Left German for the 10 got him! No, sir!
I cannot believe, I am not believing that Trevor Lee just deadlifted 265 pounds of Big Mike. Listen to this crowd! Good Lord, what a fight.
STF maybe, can he hook him?
He has won so many matches with this STF. He has held on to this title. This STF has been like Trevor Lee's rifle in a war zone. He has used it so many times to stay alive.
Oh man, look, he's breaking the grip.
Good Lord!
He's gonna try to get under, maybe hook a regal stretch.
Oh, he got the bottom rope. He got the bottom rope.
Coming into this, I had doubts if he could hook the STF effectively, and so far, my doubts are founded.
Yeah, Big Mike, he's so stocky, he's so thick.
But all that aside, all that power, all that size, all that velocity, he's still a man.
Oh man, we're talking about entering the danger zone, the hardest part of the ring, right there on the edge, and if you fall to the concrete, you could break a leg, break a hip, break your neck.
Oh man, what is he gonna do here? Maybe trying the orange crush on the apron, maybe a brain buster?
Big Mike holding on to the ropes, making sure that whatever it is never sees the light of day.
Yeah, the world may never know. Yeah. Oh man, Elliot's pissed.
Big Mike into up.
Oh man. Oh jeez!
Oh jeez! With a super kick!
No way! No way! No way!
Oh! The Philly driver!
Trevor Lee! Trevor Lee's body crumbled, Cecil!
He dropped him right on the head, neck, and shoulders! Was that Elgin's rifle in a war zone, as you put it? Will that be what nets him this championship?
Big Mike taking a few seconds on the outside, but he can afford that luxury as you see him gritting his teeth. You see fire in his eyes. Michael Elgin has come to the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium to leave as champion. Michael Elgin marching to the ring, looking like he knows what he must do next. Cecil Scott, we have talked about Trevor Lee looking lost in this title match. Michael Elgin looks immensely focused. Michael Elgin looks like a man who knows his next move.
He looks like a man that knows he's got this thing won.
They're in mixed reaction for the challenger. Make no bones about it, Michael Hogan would be a champion we could all be proud of at CWF Mid-Atlantic. But the hometown boy has captured the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium's heart, and no one wants to see Trevor Lee lose, even to a champion as great as Michael Elgin.
Man, he's going to try to suplex him all the way from the outside in.
Jeez almighty. Oh, Jesus!
Dropped him into the Falcon Arrow! We've got a new champion!
Two!
Oh, man, Trevor's still alive!
Robbie Walsh emphatically says two. Look at the face of Michael Elgin as the chants for the Mid-Atlantic champion ring out once again. This title fight continues. Michael Elgin, is the doubt creeping into his eyes? Does he have what it takes to put the champion down?
Elgin's got a long list of names, and he's beaten some of the very, very best in this business. But does he have what it takes to knock off maybe the best champion in the game today?
You could be picking fights here. I've told you this. Come on.
Elgin.
Oh, he took a little time to talk about it. I think he's singing Buckle Bomb again.
Look, come on.
See ya!
Come on, you got it.
This
come on.
Is now my house.
Oh, damn.
Champion!
One, two!
Oh, no, sir!
Trevor Lee says no! Trevor Lee says not tonight! Listen to this crowd!
I said earlier, he needs a Sportatorium crowd more than ever tonight. They have not left his side. They have not let him down. He's not going to let them down as long as he's breathing.
Look at Michael Hogan. Elgin has yet to hit the buckle bomb.
He's gone for it a couple of times.
Elgin going back to the ropes. I don't recall ever seeing Elgin use the ropes this much.
Yeah, it's almost like he's trying to think outside the box.
Oh. Trev is still rocked.
Yeah, Trevor's got a lot of cobwebs.
Trevor calling out to his people in the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium.
Top rope piranha. Oh, no. Oh, no. Elgin caught him.
Oh, dearie dear.
No, anyway,
the champion.
Mid-air adjustment.
Oh, no, Rana.
Oh, he's German.
Trevor was going for that reverse Rana. Nothing.
Woo! Got the collision course. Two.
Rushed out of the body of the challenger, but he still kicked out at two.
He's put forth such an amazing, challenging effort here. You know it's going to take a little bit extra to take down such a caliber athlete as Michael Elgin.
I got to tell you, there is nowhere else in the world I would rather be right here and right now than in this arena, watching these two athletes have this match for this championship. If you're watching us on CWF Worldwide, if you're watching us on Modern Vintage Wrestling, we thank you so much. It is our privilege to bring this title fight to your home, to your screen, to your eyes.
It's been an absolute pleasure to bring you this title reign for the last year and a half.
You're saying that like you think it may end.
Honestly, I'm starting to be a believer. I was already a believer in Michael Elgin. And I feel like it's still just one shot away from ending.
Ooh, Trevor Lee does not have his legs underneath him. Trevor Lee, Cecil Scott, I know you're a big fight fan. Those boxing matches, when the fighter doesn't have his feet underneath him, a lot of times it's curtains for him.
Absolutely. Oh! Oh, man, he's going for Splash Mountain. Got him
right in the center. Two.
Woo-hoo-hoo. Barely got that shoulder. Elgin couldn't get the foot over that shoulder.
Trevor Lee, it was almost like muscle memory. He just inched that shoulder off the canvas.
And it's a start to remind me of when Muhammad Ali lost to Ken Norton back in the 70s. Ali, he still had the swagger, he still had the skill, but Norton was the younger, stronger man. this case, Elder may not be younger, but he is a bigger, stronger man, and he has broken down the body of Trevor Lee, a body that has got thousands of miles on it in the last year and a half.
Trevor Lee wrestled in India not 48 hours ago. Right. He caught a plane all day to be here for this title defense.
Oh, God.
Oh, that's it. Whoa! The champ is alive! Oh, man, no!
Oh, oh, no, he's alive.
Has Trevor Lee's reserve gone empty? Has the champion finally given out after a week-long tour of India? After this incredibly grueling match, has the champion finally given out?
I think he used every last bit of reserve he had, kicking out of that. I don't know, I think after that Splash Mountain a couple of minutes ago, that may have been it.
What?
He said, look, Michael Elgin wanted Trevor Lee to look around the sportatorium one last time. Trevor!
SCF, no, he rolls out.
Trevor Lee may have been trying to rope a dope there, C-Bear.
Maybe, look out, he's throwing a cradle, got it!
Shoulders down!
Got him!
Trevor Lee holds on!
And Trevor Lee withstands maybe his most physical challenge yet and finds a way to knock off this international superstar, this human tank, Michael Elgin.
Your winner is still the CWF Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Champion, Trevor Lee!
And this title reign rolls on into absolute justice as he will defend against Nick Richards.
We bring you absolute justice in its entirety 1 week from tonight. But for here and now, Trevor Lee remains the man.
Crazy to think I can stand here at 30 years old and have 16 years of experience. But what comes with that experience is a lifelong dream, a lifelong journey, a lifelong of viewing the great wrestlers that came before us. I might only be 30, but through the luxury of VHS tape, I see some people in here probably don't even know what that is, which is crazy. I would put on a tape and I'd look around the building, see flags over there, see flags over there, see stands just like this, the fans just like you sitting in it. Watching guys like J.J. Dillon come out here and talk about the Four Horsemen. And watch guys like Dusty Rhodes, and Tommy Dreamer comes out here with polka dots because how important of a man Dusty Rhodes is to professional wrestling. So what I'm saying, as I get to walk into this building, the second I look around, I feel like I'm back then. I feel like I went back in time and got to wrestle with some of the greatest wrestlers that ever lived. But then I realized I didn't go back into the future. I realized that it's 2017, I walk into North Carolina and I wrestle one of the best wrestlers there's ever been. I wrestle in some of the best bands I've ever wrestled in front of in my 16-year career. I got to have a match, whether my career ends tomorrow or ends in another 16 years, that I'll never forget.
Make people talk about you. No matter what, it's still gonna hurt.
As the people standing around in the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium after the hardest match I've ever had for this heavyweight title, I am victorious again. Now, honestly, I don't know how much more of this I can handle, but when it comes to Nick Richards, at Absolute Justice, I know for damn sure I have at least one more in me. Now, Nick, I already know you can't handle me at my worst. So how about this, Nick? I want you to bring your best. You bring whatever weapons you want to bring. You looked up to Tommy Dreamer. You go see what the craziest he's ever done before, and you bring it to the CWF Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium, because at Absolute Justice, it will be Nick Richards, Trevor Lee, no DQ, no time limit for the CWF Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight title. Yeah.